and the Mullingar team have done. A addition every single time we visit here. It always is developing, and credit to the team here. So we sound the bell to clear the arena, and the first one is in. This is Manuel Feldman. It's number one. This is Fantastico Riverland to Gelding. This is by Quintero de Riverland by Jus de Pomme. It's owned by Ronico Jump. This is for Deutschland, for Germany, Manuel Feldman. And number one, Fantastico Riverland. Well, that's one time penalty with the time of 74-34 for our opening round of Manuel Feldman and Fantastico Riverland. by David Headley, number four, and Jamie Landish. Well, 4 falls and 70-43 for Jamie Landers and Jargon DW. So we go now to Jake Hunter. Jake joins us with Incredible. And this is the Stallion by Zaval Vidiel by Montreux and owned by Sandra Duffy. Jake is 27 years old and based here in Ireland now, but riding under the Australian flag. This is number five and Jake Hunter. That's a real shame for Jake Hunter. It's the last fence that falls in a time of 60.11. It is 4 falls with Incredible. Well, next to go, we return to our Irish riders, and this is Jonathan Smith with Crystal Graff. Jonathan joins us from County Tyrone and goes with this gelding. It's by Luxed, by Graff Magna, and it's owned and bred by Anthony Doherty. Combination certainly on form in our national Grand Prix circuit, and joins us as number six, Jonathan Smith. Thank you. just in underneath that time. It is two falls down, so eight falls for Jonathan Smith and Crystal Graff. Well, the bell goes now for another one of our international riders competing for Portugal under the Portuguese flag. It's Luisa Horta Osorio, and this is Jacim de Hermida, the mare that is by Milton Dumour, by Papillon Rouge. Papillon Rouge by Quintera de Hermida. This one is owned and bred by Pedro Horta Osorio. Number 7 at Jacim de Hermida and Luisa Horta Osorio. Four falls there, for unfortunately, for Luisa Horta Osorio and Yasmin de Hermida in a time of 71.44. Well, another one of our visiting riders competing under the GB flag. This is Jonathan Buxton and Gunnar de Rein. Nicolia, the gelding that's by Vigo de Aresoris, by Luxed, and this one is bred by Van Urge, owned by Samantha Sellers. Number 8 and Gino di Nicolia and Jonathan Buxton. Well, our first clear goes to Jonathan Buxton and Gino di Ricolia. It's clear in a time of 63.19. Well, a fantastic performance. It is the first clear, and it goes to a rider competing under the Great Britain flag. As we go now to number 9, and Lee Carey joins us. This is Luxidity, a gelding that's by OBOS Quality 004, and Lux said this one's owned by Niall Carey and bred by John Mulvey. It's number 9, Iverney, Luxidity, and Lee Carey. Once again, that last fence, it catches another one of our riders out, and this time it is four faults for Lee Carey at Luxidity. The time 67.84. So 92 competitors remain in our 140, which is very kindly sponsored by Aisling Byrne Sport Horses here in the Glenwood International Sand Arena. We go to number 10 now. This is absolutely Kinmar Z. It's Alex Finney, and this is the mare that's by Annex Dusinger. That's bred by Jerry Marin and owned by Gene Finney. Iverjai, number 10, and absolutely Kinmar Z, Alex Finney. Well, just the one pull down results in four faults for Alex Finney, and 65.57 is the time with absolutely Kinmar Z. We go to number 11 as we continue in sequence, and not forgetting that you can follow along on eKeep with the results as we go now to number 11, which is Cohen Williams. With Gelding, that's by De Monte Simile. This is Estrado Dubois. This is owned by Park Stables. It's number 11 and Cohen Williams. It's a clear for Cohen Williams and Estelardo Dubois with a time of 62.48. Well, a very impressive performance by our young rider. Goes into the lead, and that pushes Jonathan Buxton, our only other clear at this stage, into second. Manuel Feldman holds on to third with that one time penalty the opening round. A time of 74.34. That is how it stands with the top three at the moment in the Aisling Byrne Sport Horses 1.40. Cora Sharkey now goes next. This is number 12 at Holly Park Galloway, the gelding that is owned by Tim McDonough and bred by John McCann. It's by Castellon Galloway. This is number 12 and Cora Sharkey. Thank you. 58-27. It is clear for Cora Sharkey and Holly Park. Galloway goes into the lead with that time, 58-27. Well, that's a good 4 seconds ahead of Cohen Williams' time, of which is now second place holder, provisionally, of course, at this early stage. The three clears to date, with 88 competitors remaining. Fran O'Darren next in with us. This is Balu Derek, a mare that's by Ready by the Foretz, by Carador Z. This is owned by Auckland Ventures, and combination, our Frano was competing out in Wellington in the start of the year, and also up in Balmoral, that two-star international show last month. Goes now as number 13. This is Fran O'Darren and Babu Derek. Well, 60.17 is the time on the clock there. It is four jumping penalties, so a total of four with Balu Derek and Fran O'Darren. Well, this is our 1.40 competition. It is the second FEI competition here, part of the two-star Mullingar International Horse Show. It is a pleasure to have you along with us this morning. And not forgetting that the competitions later on, we will return to our national competitions. Yesterday, seen some fantastic performances, part of that Horse Sport Ireland qualifying events. We'll have those finals coming up later this afternoon. Edward Doyle Jr. now, and this is Pembroke, King of Kings. Number 14 on our start list, the gelding that is by the Montes Simile by Luck Said. And this one is bred by the Kilmashow Stud, which is owned by Joanne Fox. Number 14 and Edward Jr. Doyle. Well, it is the 8 false for Edward Jr. Doyle and Pembroke King of Kings. The time, 69.38. Daniel McAlinden has the bell now and joins us with AHG White Rock Dr. Cruz. This is a gelding by Indoctro and bred by Anne Gannon Clancy. This was owned by Luisa Hortor Osorio, and Daniel joins us from County Galway, number 15, and Daniel McAlinden. Four faults and a time of 68.29 for Daniel McAlinden and AHG Wadrock, Dr. Cruz. Ilya Renner, and this is number 16. This is S. Coco Can and the mare that's by Canaan, by Acrobat 2, and this one is owned by Nicholas Jalali and Nicole Pavitt, number 16, and Lilia Bremer. It falls in a time of 68.32 for Lilia Bremer and E.S. Coco Can. Harry Marshall has the bell now. This is Tango. It's a mare that's by Cornel Blinsky and by Lawton's Flight. Harry owns, rides, and also bred this one, and Harry joins us from County Antrim. Was competing in Villamora at the start of the year. And a couple of placings at that three-star show. Joins us now here in Mullingar as number 17, Harry Marshall. Four falls there for Harry Marshall, unfortunately, at fence number 5, with a time of 67.61. They go now to Derek McConnell, and Derek joins us with in-laws Manolo, the gelding that's by Corland and owned now by Saoirse Hennessy, bred by Thomas Hester. This is number 19 and Derek McConnell. Clear for Derek McConnell and in-laws Manolo. The time 61.47. That is good enough for provisional second. Well, our young rider Cora Sharkey still holds on to that top spot with a time to beat of 58.27. Will it be our next competitor, Jim Donoghue, that takes on the challenge of beating that time set by Cora? Well, this is Cool Derek Cloverlad at number 20, Rafia August Gelding, that's by Glenfin Clover and owned by Niamh O'Donoghue. Number 20 and Jim Donoghue. False and 63.16 for Jim Donoghue and Kildare Cloverlat. And we go now to number 22 and Sven Hadley joins us with Ferrand Bleu Vidien. This is the gelding by De Montesimile by Nav Dreyf and owned by Hadley Sport Horses, number 22, Rafiha Doe and Sven Hadley. Thank you. for Foss, and it is the fastest four faulting time with a time of 59.03 for Sven Hadley, Phenomen Blue VDM. Well, the four clears to date. One on one time penalty. That opening round by Manuel Feldman, and the time of 74.34. But the leading time is our young rider. Core Sharkey still holds on to it, 58.27. Well, next in, it is our international rider representing Ireland lately in the Nations Cup in Rome. Mikey Pender joins us with Chaco Bay. This is the stallion. That's by Chaquito, by Hibs. That is owned by Al Sharara Stables. Number 23, and Mikey Pender. Well, of course he can. It's clear all the way into the lead with a time of 57.08. Mikey Pender and Chaco Bay. Well, making it look easy there. Mikey Pender and Chaco Bay now in the lead with the leading time of 57.08. It is just 1 second ahead of our young rider, Cora Sharkey's time, who is now second place holder of this competition here, which is the second FEI competition. Our top six is displayed on our board here on the arena. So Mikey Pender first, second Cora Sharkey, third Derek McConnell, fourth Cohen Williams, fifth is Jonathan Buxton, and sixth is Manuel Feldman. Ashling Burns Sport Horse is the very proud sponsor of this competition. A Longford native and currently based in Cheshire in the UK. Regular competitor here at the Mullingar International Horse Show and competes on the Spring and Autumn Sunshine Tour. It is an absolute pleasure to have her on board for the sponsorship of our 1m40. And not forgetting that the top 50 riders will qualify for our event, with 74 riders entered into our competition here. We continue with Susan Fitzpatrick, and on course now is number 24 at Keatonstown, Scorpulous Joker, gelding. That's owned by Sharon Fitzpatrick, 24, and Susan Fitzpatrick. Well, four faults for Susan Fitzpatrick at Keatonstown, Scorpulous Joker, in a time of 62.18. Well, great to have some of our stalls over by the show office, including Jumpin' Action Photography, the official photographer of the show, and Equijump Fergal over there at the stand, and multiple opportunities to go over and have a conversation and browse with some of our stocks. Well, starting now, it is Richard Howley, and this is number 25, Madagascar Derwis Hage, the gelding that is owned by Amanda Derbyshire and Penelope Shaw. Number 25, and Richard Howley. That is the eight faults there. Two poles down for Richard Howley and Managaska Dwyshan Hagen. We go to number 26, and Yearney Park Baloo is the stallion that Wesley Ryan joins us with now. Owns this one also, and bred by Ian Perry. Number 26, and competing with the Irish flag, it's Wesley Ryan. So by Wesley Ryan not indicating to us here in the grand jury that he has retired, that is elimination for Yearney Park Baloo as per FEI rules. Well, we go now to Owen Brennan and to Scola M. This is the gelding that's by Singapore, by Marisaur. This one's owned by Tim Brennan. It's number 27. And Discola M, Owen Brennan. $68.78 and a clear for Owen Brennan and Escola M. Well, that is clear round number six. The perfect six clear rounds at the moment. And that puts Owen into provisional sixth with Mikey Pender leading at 57.08, the time to beat. We go now to Molly Hughes Bravo, and this is HHS Fortune. The mare that's by Katoki by Douglas, which is owned and bred by Marion Hughes and riding under the Portuguese flag. It's Molly Hughes Bravo. 63-01. Molly Hughes Bravo is clear and goes into provisional fifth. Maintenant, numéro 29, et avec Antoine de Vildeur, avec Chic of Aranca. L'athlète est français. Et number 29 is next to go, Chic of Aranca. It's Antoine de Vildeur. This is a gelding by Demont de Simile by Cruising. Owns and also rides this one. This is number 29 and Antoine de Vildeur. Well, it is the four for Antoine de Vildeur and Chic of Aranca. Well, the time there, 60.55. So we go to number 30. Tommy Halford gets the bell there. This is Greenville Darko, a stallion. It's by Walter Preff, by Marlene Venables. This is owned by Louise Halford. It's number 30 and Tommy Halford. So four falls for Tommy Halford and Greenville Darko, 66.79. Well, Stephen Gibbons joins us now from the west of Ireland. This is Cassius Zed, the stallion. That's by Cavis Zed, up to date M. And it's owned now by Lauren Hugh. It's number 31. Ever Traha Hin August Cassius Set, Stephen Gibbons. Thank you. Well, 62-76, it's a clear for Stephen Gibbons and Cassius Zed. Provisional fifth for Stephen Gibbons. Well, Ashingburn Sport Horse is the very proud sponsor of the second FEI competition of our show. This is a 1.40 meter with 50 riders to qualify. 74 riders entered with 101 participants, so 101 horses entered. And it's great to have Ashingburn on board. This is regular. Ashling's a regular competitor at Mullingar International Show and competes on the Spring and Autumn Sunshine Tour. Is the owner of Bespoke Tourism Company and Journey Through Ireland, and they create personalised tours of Ireland for many US-based clientele, and a generous sponsor and supporter of the two-star Mullingar Horse Show for many years. So absolutely fantastic to have Ashingburn Sport Horses, the proud sponsor of the 1.40 meter. Well, next to go here, it is number 32, and riding under the Irish flag, it's Martha Hughes Bravo, with just the two competitors to our first arena maintenance break. This is HHS Figueroa, the gelding that's by Cavalier Royale, and bred by Marion Hughes, owned by Bravo Hughes. Number 32, Iver Trotha Doe, August HHS Figueroa, Martha Hughes Bravo. Well, it is the four faults there for Martha Hughes Bravo and HHS Figueroa, the time 63.30. I'll go to number 33 now, and Toe Kulaj is next to go. This is Calox, it's the stallion that's by Cador 5 by Lordanos. It's owned by Ronico Jump. For Deutschland, this is Tobe Kulaj at 33. advantage is 12 jumping faults there. In a time of 77.80, that incurs 4 time penalties. So total of 16 for Tobias Kulaga and Kallax. So last horse before we have our arena maintenance break, it's Holly Miller, and Holly competes under the GB flag. This is Overan Vantilov. This is a stallion. Is by Alorado van de Schoof, by Wimmenmoed van de Arenberg. Number 34, and Holly Miller. That is the four jumping there, and with the steady pace, it's 74.92 on the clock, so one time penalty for Holly Miller and Overan Vantilov. Well, that does conclude the first third of our competition, which is very kindly sponsored by Ashleyburn Sport Horses. We will have an arena maintenance break now and be back with you in just a moment. Superman. Well, ready to restart our competition for the second third. This is the Aisling Byrne Sport Horses CSI two-star table 8, 1.40 height on the course. Our course design team being led here in the Glenwood International Sand Arena by our FEI course designer, Rafael Suarez. Deciding to move up, it is number 55 and Lee Carey. Lee joins us with this one. It's by Ascaro Holst. It's the stud book is Ascaro Holst. This is by Galvu A. And number 55, Lee Carey. Well, number 55 at Lee Carey with Arazo Mazer and a time of 69.65. We go now to Jay Hunter and Chavo Che. This is the gelding that's by Cornet Blinsky. And Carell, this is owned by Carl Hanley Sport Horses and bred by Linda Mayer. Competing under the Australian flag, this is Jake Hunter and Chapo Che. Well, just slightly over our time allowed of 74 seconds with a time of 74.34. It's four jumping, one time penalty, a total of five for Jay Hunter and Chapo Che. Edward Junior Doyle is next to go as we return back on track to number 35 and Quick Bill. This is the stallion that's by Flexible by Quick Star, and Edward owns and rides this one. It's Edward Doyle Jr. Thank you.
it's clear for Edward Jr. Doyle. The time is 67:38. So that is provisionally into 8th place for Edward Jr. Doyle. And clear with a quick bill as Mikey Penner still leads at 57:08. 9 clears to date, one time penalty, that was the opening round by Manuel Filesman. As we go now to Luisa Horta Osorio back in with us, this time with Balnavera Girl, Duvo Z. This combination was able to take 4th. In the Table A 1 meter 40 up in Balmoral last month, that was a 2-star also, joins us riding under the Portuguese flag. This is the mare that's by Biscuit Balu Van de Mezzelpel. Owns and rides this one, 36. Well, the four faults in a time of 69.64 for Luisa Horta Osorio, Balnavera Girl, Devo Z. Number 37 and Mackenzie Healy goes with Domar van der Neerheiden. It's the gelding that's by Omar by Gabu A. This is bred by Erica Van Giel and owned by Rani Ratlett. This is 37 and Mackenzie Healy. Well, it is 2 poles down for Mackenzie Healy, and that results in 8 faults in a time 64.92 with Doma van de Neerheiden. We go to number 38 now, and riding with the Irish Defence Forces. This is MSH, Claire Galway, the mare that's by Cornel Oblinsky and owned by the Minister for Defence. This is Lieutenant McKeely Byrne. Thank you. Well, four faults for Lieutenant Byrne and MSH Clare Galway in a time of 68.95. We go now to Angelo Warris at number 39. This is Demont de la Mer, the stallion that's by Demont de Simile by Eurocommerce Berlin. It's bred and owned by Hugh Ward, it's number 39, and Angelo Warris. Well, it is the top pole of fence number 9 that falls for Angela Warris, and good time of 58.44, that is 4 falls with Demont de la Mer. We go now to number 40, as that is the fastest 4 fault, fall falter of the day so far in this competition is Angela Warris. So the 9 clears to date, as we welcome Nicoline Dresla. This is a combination from Denmark and goes with Chico, the gelding that's by Chaco Blue by Calestial. Well, a clear and the time 64.23 for Nicoline Dresla and Chico. Well, we go now to number 41 at Salisborough BHF Bombay. This is Jim Donohoe from County Wexford, goes with this gelding with Spy Louis Dam. Jim owns this one, co-owns with Kevin Egan. So number 41 and Jim Donohoe. Thank you. Well, 12 horse there for Jim Donohoe and Soulsborough, BHF Bombay, 65-69. Next in, it's back in once again for Manuel Feldman and Mihir van Lentamal. This is a stallion that's by Emerald by Toulon, and this one is owned by Nicole Walker. It's number 42 and Manuel Feldman. Well, a clear and the time of 68.19 for Manuel Feldman and Mihir van de Lentamar. Well, we go now to a combination that performed really well in the opening round of the Show Jumping Ireland Premier Grand Prix in Barnedown and Gorey in County Wexford. This is DHF Liftoff, the mare that's by Harlequin Ducarel, and this one's bred by Stephen Kane. It's now owned by the Greg Broderick Ballypatrick International Team. This is number 43, DHF Liftoff and Kevin Gallagher. Well, what a performance, 58-23. Clear all the way for Kevin Gallagher, DHF Liftoff. It's good enough to go into second position. Well, what a performance. It really is heating up here this afternoon in Mullingar, the second of our FEI international competitions, and very proudly sponsored by Aisling Byrne Sport Horses. We go now to Elaine O'Neill. This is Olympic GL FVD. This is the gelding by Galesco Van Pamal. That's owned by Keith Ennis, number 44. Well, it's clear at 69.11 for Elaine O'Neill and Olympic GI FVD. Well, that makes it 13 clear rounds to date. One still remains on one time penalty. Mikey Pender still leading. 57.08 to Sophie Richards from County Wexford joins us now. This is BP Arctic Blue. The gelding that's by Pacino de Muse, by Chaco Blue, and co-owned with Sophie Richards and GBBS International. 45 and Sophie Richards. Well, a clear round for Sophie Richards and BP Arctic Blue, 69.96. Next in, it's Annabelle Francis. This is Ivan, a gelding that's by Nimbus or by Damero. Rides with the New Zealand, number 46. Well, four falls at 74.60. It's four jumping and one time penalty with that time. So a total of five for Annabelle Francis. Well, as the sun beams down on the Glenwood International Sand Arena, we go to number 48, and Daniel Carroll joins us with Hollywood. This is the Merits by Zirocco Blue VDL and owned by Breda Carroll, number 48. Thank you. 12 falls in a time of 71.02 for Daniel Carroll and Hollywood. To number 49 at TMSH Lady Magella. This is the mare that's by OBS Quality 004 by Diamond Serpent. This one is bred by Peter Murdoch and owned by Alan McCroosh. This is number 49 and Trudy McCroosh. The time is certainly okay, 61.93, and it is 8 falls for Trudy McCroosh and TMSH Lady Magella. Next in will be number 50, and this is Daniel McAlinden with Java QP, the stallion that's owned by Vasco Cantomos. This is by Milton Demure. This is number 50 and Daniel McAlinden. Well, with the time of 75.91, that is 2 time penalties and 4 jumping, unfortunately, occurred at that last fence. So a total of 6 for Daniel McAlinden and Java QP. Well, Hannah O'Shea is next in with us, and Hannah goes with this stallion that Susan O'Shea owns, bred by Gustit Lutzfitz. This is by Centadel, by Chaco Blue. It's number 51, Cento Blue, and Hannah O'Shea. we're jumping. And with the time, 76.02, that is three-time penalty. So a total of seven for Han O'Shea and Cento Blue. Well, we go now to number 53 and Harry Marshall. This is Daylight VHSZ. And this combination took first in Villamora in the CSI 3-star two-phase 1-meter 40 competition back in February. Joins us with this mare, that's By Douglas, owns and rides this one. It's number 53 and Harry Marshall. It falls for Harry Marshall and Daylight VHS said in a time 69.84. The bell goes now for a combination that was recently competing in that two-star event in Balmoral up in Ulster. This is number 54, Patrick Hickey and Carmel Sky. The gelding, that's By Conor Oblinsky, by RVDL Douglas. This one is owned by GRS Bloodstock and bred by Paul Brady, number 54, and Patrick Hickey. Close to that time, 72.90, but it is just the one pole down, so that's four falls for Patrick Hickey and Carmel Sky. We go now to Lelia Bremer, and this is Memphis Van de Vaart, a gelding that's by Elvis the Pooch, by Up Chic. This one is bred by Natalie Goosens and owned by Tessa Bremer. Riding for the Great Britain, it's number 56 and Memphis Van de Hart, Lelia Bremer. All right. Just the four faults incurred for Lilia Bremer at Memphis Van de Vaart. Time was 68.95. Poor Sharkey has the bell with number 57, and this is Lisboy Mermis. It's gelding that is by Mermis or by Cruising. It's bred by Sean Kevins and owned by Joe Sharkey. Number 57 and Cora Sharkey. That's a shame. It's the last fence that catches Cora Sharkey at the four faults incurred on Lisboy Mermis and a time of 57.92. We go now to Holly Lenehan. Holly, just aged 19, joins us now with this stallion. This is by Ustinov by Clover Flush and bred by Declan Lenehan and also owned by Declan. Holly recently moved to Australia to continue with her veterinary career and rejoins us back here in Ireland, but competes under the Australian flag as number 52, and Kavalov and Holly Lennon. Holly, that is a shame. It is that last fence once again that catches one of our competitors out. This time 62.25, and it is four faults for Holly Lenehan and Kalinoff. Well, next is Irish international rider Rhys Williams. A young rider at that, and a really fantastic RDS Dublin Horse Show last year, and indeed in that international six and seven-year-old competition in the RDS, and took first in a recent national Grand Prix sponsored by Gain and Alltech. This is Rhys Williams with Cowboy Baloo. It's number 58, and this is by Baloo du Reventon by Poker 49, and this is owned by Adrian Williams and Paula Williams, number 58, and Rhys Williams. Thank you. Well, look at that time on the screen, 53.52. It is an incredible performance by Rhys Williams, and Cowboy Ballou goes into the lead. Well, that is absolutely incredible. Have a look at the screen. It's going to update very shortly. It will mean that Mikey Pender goes into second position with a time of 57.08. Well, that is an incredible 5 seconds or so ahead of Mikey's time. It is into the lead for Rhys Williams. Joanne Blair now in with us, and we will have a look at the scoreboard very soon. But Joanne Blair starts now as number 60 at Tranquility Bay. This is a gelding that's by Emerald by Luxet. Well, just in underneath that time allowed with a time of 73.64. It's clear for Joanne Blair and Tranquility Bay. Well, six competitors to our next arena maintenance break as we go to number 61. This is Ella Clancy with Shooting Star, the gelding that is by Voss, by a doctoral, and owned by Liam Clancy, 61. By electing to jump a fence, already jumped. That indicates to us here in the grand jury that Ella Clancy has decided to return to Shooting Star. We go now to Fran O'Dermot, and this is number 62. This is AFG Watt Rock Cruise Down, a gelding. That's by Cruising's Mickey Finn, by Touchdown. Spread by Anne Gannon Clancy. This one's owned by Francis Derwin. A combination that took first in Wellington in Florida. part of that under 25 international event, the table 8, 1.45 meters. Joins us now as number 62, Francis Derwin. Is so unfortunate. It is that last fence that falls for Fran O'Derwin and AHG White Rock cruise down. The time was great, 57:29. It is unfortunate. Going out to number 63, and this is Zodiac du Buisson Z, the stallion that's by Vidal Zarocco, blue by Dutch Capital Z. This is Richard Howley, number 63. Well, 62:54. It is our 17th clear out to date. That is Richard Halley, Zodiac du Buisson Z into provisional seventh. Well, three competitors to our next arena maintenance break as we come to the end of this section. And once again, our thanks to Aisling Byrne Sport Horses, the sponsor of the 1.40 meters, the second FEI international competition of today. This is Owen Brennan on course now. Number 65 in Limestone, Barry Hill, Louis, the mare that's by King's Cornet, owned by Tim Brennan. 65 and Owen Brennan. Once again, it is that last fence that falls and catches this time Owen Brennan and Limestone Barry Hill Louis. An unfortunate four faults, 61.16. And we go to number 66. The leaderboard currently displayed on our screen. The top four at leading time of our young rider, Rhys Williams, 53.52 is the time to beat. As we go to Nicholas Connors at number 66. This is Follet Amaut, the gelding that's by Windows Van Het Cottersveld by Le Arc de Triomphe. This is owned by Al Connors, number 66, and Nicholas Connors. It's just the four faults for Fonet de Amaut and Nicholas Connors, time 68.98. Well, our last one to our break, it's Paul Beecher in with us now. This is Glamstone, a stallion by Berlin, by Sydney, and this one is owned by Serena Van Coolen, 67, and Paul Beecher. So the bell goes now for Paul Beecher. This is number 67. Well, just the four. The time was 72.02 for Paul Beecher and Glamstone. Well, that concludes the second third of our competition. Just the last third to go, obviously, with a couple of competitors, approximately 40 competitors left to go. And our 1 meter 40, sponsored by Ashley Byrne Sport Horses. We'll be back with you after our arena minutes. Thank you. Well, our thanks to the arena party, and having completed the arena maintenance now, we will restart the last third of our competition. This is our Aisling Burns Sport Horses Table A 1 meter 40 competition number 2 on our FEI schedule. Aisling is a Longford native and regular competitor here, and the owner of Bespoke Tourism Company Journey Through Ireland, and a generous supporter and sponsor of our two-star show for many, many years. And our thanks to Aisling Burns Sport Horses for their very kind sponsorship. We go to our next competitor with a reminder of the top six available on the screen at the moment. Rhys Williams is leading at 53.52. Mikey Pender, 57.08, is second. Third, Kevin Gallagher, 58.23. And third, Kevin Gallagher, DHF liftoff, as the bell goes to restart the competition with a time to beat of 53.52. Alex Finney, the 19-year-old, joins us with MHS style. This is the mare that's by Canaan. It's bred by Ita Brennan and owned by Gene Finney, number 68. And Alex Finney. A great way to restart us. It's a clear all the way for Alex Finney, MHS style, 60.57. Well, that is good enough to go into provisional fifth with that time for Alex, as we go now to Paddy Reap. The 16-year-old competes now as number 69. Combination of Tuck fifth in Gloria Minore, the Table A 1 meter 40 in Italy. Joins us with Creva Special, the mare that is a 13-year-old by Kamar de Harzed, by Harlequin Ducorel, bred by Ronnie Hollinger, owned by Jonathan Reap, number 69. What a performance, 57.32. It's clear all the way and into provisional third for Paddy Reap. Well, what a performance from a 16-year-old performing at this level. It is absolutely incredible. As we go to number 71, can he retake that top spot? It is Mikey Pender, currently holds on to second. This is HHS Cornetta, a mare that's by Conor Leblinski. It's by Accurato, bred by Marion Hughes, owned by Bravo Hughes, 71, and Mikey Pender. steady pace by Mikey Pender, 71.86. It is clear on HHS Cornetta. Well, we go now to number 70, and Joshua Lynch joins us with Otis Van Hert of Ivanshoff, the stallion that's by Canaan and owned by Joshua Lynch himself. Number 70, and Joshua Lynch. Well, just the four, and a time of 71.26 for Joshua Lintz and Otis Van Het Vivenshoff. Niamh McAvoy joins us on this one that's owned by the Greg Broderick Ballypatrick team. This one is bred by Noel Cawley, and it's a gelding that's by Flexible Hibernia. And Niamh won the two-star Balmoral Grand Prix last year in that Temple Patrick Welcome Limerick, and was competing in the Andalusia Sunshine Tour, and of course took and won that Longines ranking class. Number 72. Well, Niamh raises her hand to us here in the Grand Jury to indicate she is retiring Hibernia. Derek McConnell at number 73. This is Longfield Quinn Louis. A mare that's by Contender and bred by Seamus Dre and owned now by Derek himself. The 73 at Derek McConnell. Well, it is the four falls for Derek McConnell at Longfield Quinn Louis with a time 59.92. Hughes Bravo now joins us after that win in Madrid, part of that CSI One Star event. Joins us as 74 and HHS Vancouver. Rides under the Portuguese flag with this gelding. Espion Doctoro by Don Juan de la Bouverie. Read by Marion Hughes, note by Bravo Hughes. 74 and Molly Hughes Bravo. Well, that was an incredible finish over that last fence. It is clear for Molly Hughes Bravo in a time of 61.59 with HHS Vancouver. Well, we return to our Irish riders and to Katie Nallon now. This is number 75. This is Javis True Colours, a gelding that's by Louis Dam. And this one's bred and owned by Judy Murphy, number 75. Well, a clear in the time of 67.31. It's clear for Kitty Nallon, Javis, True Colours. Well, 22 clear rounds to date as we continue at number 76. This is Madeline Allen and Kayla Sue de Raffaello Z, a mare that's owned by Madeline herself and bred by Johan Gihops, 76, and Madeline Allen. Well, another clear, and this time it's Madeline Allen to Kelasu de Rafialfo Zed in a time of 68.61. Well, let's have a look at the leaderboard as it stands at the moment. Rhys Williams leads it 53.52. Second, Mikey Pender 57.08. Third, Paddy Reap 57.32. Fourth, Kevin Gallagher. And fifth, Cora Sharkey. Sixth, Alex Finney. That is the top six. Richard Kearns approaches the start with Mirma CK. This is the mare that's by Marius Clarius by Quality Time. This is bred by Dermot Gormley and number 77. It's both the elements of the doubles, the first parts fall, and that results in 8 falls for Richard Kearns, Mirma CK. Ily Barry next to go, number 78, and Gary the Druid, Lemoncello. This is bred by Jerry McCogan and owned by Joe Barry. This is 78 and Amy Barry. Well, a nice time of 56.14. It is clear for Amy Barry. Garner Druid, Lemoncello goes into provisional second place. Well, that pushes Mikey Pender into third as Rhys Williams still holds on to that top spot with a time of 53.52, and it is still 3 seconds faster. Then our second place holder, Amy Barry, now goes into that position as we go to 79 and Abigail Boland. This is Quinton Kay. This is a gelding that is owned by Mary Boland. 71.55 is the time on the clock and clear for Abigail Boland and Quinton Kerr. Well, next in, it's number 80, and this is Clem McMahon. This is Athenia Clover Trend, the combination that took first in the two-star Balmoral event. It was table A, 1.45 meters. As this is the gelding by Future Trend, by Clover Clon the Seventh. And this one's bred by John Joe Tierney, owned by Derry Kingston. This is number 80 and Clem McMahon. Well, it's clear, and a time of 70.41 for Clem McMahon, Athenia Clover Trend. Well, back in our Glenwood International Sound Arena, we have Wesley Ryan and Tiger Ballou. This is the Stallion. It's a 10-year-old by Ballou du Rouet by Cardento. This is owned by Stephen Gee. It's number 81 and Wesley Ryan.
Well, four jumping at time of 76.97. That occurs three time penalties, so a total of seven for Wesley Ryan and Tiger Ballou. Well, next in and has the bell, it is our European Bursary Award winner, Sean Monaghan, currently on that bursary scheme. And joins us as number 82. This is Ian Cassius. The gelding that's by Cabochon. And it's number 82, Sean Monaghan. Well, a steady pace and some long turns there results in a time of 75.35, which is two time penalties for Sean Monaghan and Ian Cassius. The bell goes for number 83 to see if he can beat his brother's time of 53.52. Cohen Williams goes next. Combination that took first in the Nations Cup in Kathanga, with Kathanga in Glora Minore in Italy, part of that Youth or Young Nations Cup. This is number 83, and the mare that's by Cantargos, it's owned by Arian Williams and Paula Williams, number 83. Well, 63.44 and a clear for Cohen Williams and Kotchenga. Well, next in it is Commandant Jeff Curran, and this is DHF Alliance. The mare that's by Art VDL Douglas by Luck Said and bred by Paul Douglas. The Commandant rides on behalf of the Minister for Defence based in the Army Equitation School in McKee Barracks in Dublin. This is number 84 and Commandant Curran. Into the lead, what a performance by Commandant Jeff Curran and DHF Alliance. Well, that was absolutely spectacular by the member of the Defence Forces, Commandant Jeff Curran, in the lead, 53.12. Well, we thought it couldn't be beaten, but that pushes Rhys Williams into second position in a time of 53.52. It is just fractions of a second dividing the top two. Well, we go now to Robin Morn and Cushla's Friday. This is the gelding by Hector van de Ajaovi. It's bred by Peter Finley and owned by Vera Griffin, number 85. Well, a gentle dismount there, so hopefully you're okay, Robin. It's a real shame. Robin Morn and Cushla's Friday parting company. Well, our top three at the moment, Commandant Jeff Curran with the time of 53.12. Second is Rhys Williams, 53.52. Third, Amy Barry, 56.14. This is the Aisling Byrne Sport Horses 1.40 meter. And a reminder that top 50 athletes will qualify. And we continue now with number 86. Mark Duffy just receives the bell there with Figaro, the 7th. It's a gelding that's by Quality Time, by Optimist. And this one is owned by Karen Gilgan. Number 86 and Mark Duffy. Well, four faults and a time of 65.05 for Mark Duffy and Figaro the 7th. Well, as we wait for our next competitor to make their way to the arena, let's have a look at the top six of the Aisling Byrne Sport Horses. Great to have Aisling Byrne with us, sponsoring the competition here and in the lead. Comment on Jeff Curran. Look at those times of the top two. So, so close displayed on our screen. Number 88 and Rufus. This is a gelding that's owned by David Henley. Jamie Landers decides to move up. Four faults there for Jimmy Landers in 72.94. Ashley McGinnis now, and number 87, this is Chilibard Hank, a gelding that's by DeMonte Simile, and bred by Marion Power. Owned by Hazel McGinnis, this is 87 and Aisling McGinnis. Thank you. Well, 12 false in the time of 69.54 for Aisling McGuinness and Chilibard Hank. Well, to see if he can beat the boss's time, Commandant Jeff Curran, it is Lieutenant James White joins us now, and also, of course, a member of the Army Equitation School. This is Hawthorne Hill, a gelding that's by Carlento and bred by Jerry Quinn, riding on behalf of the Minister for Defence. This is Lieutenant White. That's a shame for Lieutenant White and Hawthorne Hill, that last fence, the pole falls, resulting in four falls. Well, Aisling Burn Sport Horse is the proud sponsor of our second FEI competition. He's a Longford native and currently based in Cheshire in the UK, and the owner of Bespoke Tourism Company Journey Through Ireland, which creates a lot of bespoke planning and journeys of tours of Ireland, especially for US-based clientele. Great to have Aisling back on board again as the proud sponsor of this competition with a prize fund of €1,000. Not forgetting that 10 different nations are represented here at the two-star International Mullingar Horse Show. Pleasure to have you along with us here this afternoon. Not forgetting that the competitions coming up after this will be our Horse Sport Ireland national competitions. That will include the 5-year-old, 6- and 7-year-old. Those are the finals, which the qualifying events were yesterday, and those competitors lucky enough to get invited to the final will compete with a prize fund of the 5- and 6-year-old of €2,500, and the 7-year-old event, which will be the final event of today, €2,880 of a prize fund. This is the Glenwood International Sand Arena, and a pleasure to have Glenwood as the main sponsor of the International Sand Arena. A huge credit to the entire Mullingar team and the Fagan family. Always improvements every year we come back to the International Show, developing and developing. It's great to see one of the top, if not one of the elite equestrian centres of Ireland here in the Midlands, in County Westmeath. Not forgetting the stalls, of course, over by the show office. Wide variation. And hello to our viewers online, of course, as we wait. Number 94 has decided to move up to keep us going. Jonathan Smith, our thanks goes to, as Jonathan joins us with Premier Spirit. Is a gelding that says by Premier Sport by Herbs de Rave, and this is bred and owned by Dominic Rice. It's number 94, and Jonathan Smith joins us from County Tyrone. Well, 8 jumping penalties there, unfortunately, for Jonathan Smith. With the time of 77.30, that is 4 time penalties, so a total of 12 with Premier Spirit. We go to Sive Slattery, and this is Prada. It's a mare that is by Catwalk the Fort, which is owned by Josephine Slattery. Number 93 at Sive Slattery. Well, the two stops means elimination under FEI rules for, unfortunately, for Slive Slattery at Prada. Well, we display the leaderboard on the fantastic new addition to the International Sand Arena, sponsored by Glenwood. We have our new screen, so let's have a look at the leaderboard as it stands as we wait for our next competitor to make their way to the Glenwood International Sand. It is 6 to Kevin Gallagher at the moment. 58.23 just clings on. As fifth is our young rider, Paddy Reap, 57.32. Fourth is Mikey Pender, 57.08. Third, Amy Barry, the only female in our top six, with the time of 56.14, holds on to third at this late stage. Reese Williams, 53.52. And what an incredible performance by Commandant Curran, with a time of 53.12. That is the time to beat, with just the 6 left to go. 28 clear rounds to date, and 1 with 1 time penalty. As we go to number 91. This is Timmy Brennan and Damada Della Caccia. This is a mare that's by the Monte Simile and owned by Tim Brennan. 91 and Timmy Brennan. Ah, that's a shame, Timmy. It's the last fence to falls for Timmy Brennan and Damada Della Caccia in a time of 66.18. Number 97, Anna Carway. This is Ajishio, the gelding that's by Corantino and Quidam the Revel. This is owned by Helen Carway. Number 97 and Anna Carway. Well, 66.30 and a clear for Anna Carway and Ajishio. So we would like to remind all our spectators and athletes that dogs should be on leads at all times. We do appreciate your cooperation with that request. We would like to invite Joe Byrne, if you are about, to come to the judges' box as we are approaching the end of our competition. So Joe Byrne to the judges' box. Number 98 now at Jonathan Buxton. This is Stridey's Josie, a mare that's by... Don VHPZ by Quintero B and visiting from Great Britain, number 98, Jonathan Buxton. $68.59, it's clear for Jonathan Buxton and Stridey's Josie. Well, we go to our next rider, of which is also a rider from Great Britain. This is Annabelle Shields and Creva Charisma, the mare that is a 13-year-old by Kamara de Hallerzed. This is bred by Ronnie Hollinger. And it's co-owned with Annabelle Shields and Robert Shields. Number 99 from Great Britain, Annabelle Shields. Well, a nice time of 59.78. It's clear for Annabelle Shields and Quiva Charisma. So we will be having a mounted presentation very shortly for the top six as we go to Shane O'Reilly with BWE Nonstop Caprice. This is by Nonstop, by Artist, and it's bred by Brian McConville. It's 101, Shane O'Reilly. Well, a total of 8 there. It's 68.70 on the clock for Shane O'Reilly and BWE Nonstop Caprice. Well, our last rider to join us here in the Glenwood International Sand Arena. This is the last one to go, part of the Ashley Byrne Sport Horses 1m40 Table A. Christopher Connell gets the bell with MHS 19 as number 102. This is the gelding by OVS Quality 004, bred by Ita Brennan, and owned and ridden by Christopher Connell. Well, 69 seconds on the nose. It's four falls for Christopher Connell at MHS 19. Well, that does conclude the competition here in the Glenwood International Sand Arena, the Ashley Byrne Sport Horses Table A 1m40. We will announce the results in just a moment. Once again, we invite Joe Byrne to the judges' box here. So, Joe Byrne for our presentation. Well, the results have been checked and verified of the top six. Well, the results of our Aisling Burns Sport Horses 1 meter 40 FEI International Table A competition. Sixth goes to Kevin Gallagher, DHF Liftoff, in a time of 58.23. Fifth goes to Paddy Reap and Creva Special, 57.32. Fourth goes to Mikey Pender and Chaco Bay in a time of 57.08. Third goes to Amy Barry and Gary the Drug Lemoncello, 57.14. Second goes to Reese Williams and Cowboy Baloo. And please put your hands together as he joins us here in the arena for the winner, Commandant Jeff Curran, DHF Alliance. Our thanks once again to Aisling Burns Sport Horses, the proud sponsor of our 1 meter 40, as we have our presentation here in the Glenwood International Sand Arena. This is day number two of the two-star International Horse Show of Mullingar. Today is the first day of our FEI competitions, and this was the second of those competitions. Huge congratulations to Commandant Jeff Curran and DHF Alliance with a time of 53.12. And of course, congratulations to the entire Defence Forces team. Second goes to Reese Williams and Cowboy Baloo. Third goes to Amy Barry and Gary Nadruk Lemoncello. We will go back to second then, and to Reese Williams with Cowboy Baloo. So second to Reese. Fourth goes to Mikey Pender and Chaco Bay. Fourth to Mikey and fifth to Paddy Reap with Creva Special. And sixth goes to Kevin Gallagher with DHF Liftoff. Well, our thanks to Aisling Byrne Sport Horses, the proud sponsor of our competition here. With the presentation complete, now leading us off in our lap of honour, it is the top six, and leading us, it is Commandant Jeff Curran. The winner of the 140 Tivoli, Commandant Jeff Curran. Well, that does conclude the FEI International Jumping for today. We will now start our national show jumping competitions. We will be back with you very shortly.